Whatever words you may use and hide, love is nothing but a simple caring. If somebody says that he loves you, or if you say you love somebody, what do you mean? You give your attention and he gives his attention to you, that's all. Bring it and give a small or down-to-earth explanation, only then we can proceed. But I see everybody is just flying. And I think you all will give much bigger sermon than me. If I let someone of you be here, I think they will speak in a much better way than me. But totally impractical. Love is divine. Love is compassion. Love is God. All these things are simple, foolish statements which you only read. Which you have nothing experienced. One thing, they are all true in the person who is enlightened, his life, in your life. Be down to earth. At least let you know where you stand. Only then you can start progressing. In your life, love means nothing but either giving attention or having attention. That's all. If somebody gives his attention to you, you say he loves you. When somebody is attended by you, you say you love him. That's all. Is there anything else? Nothing else. Whatever else you say is from books, not from your life. We have a long way to reach the state love is compassion or love is divine. Yesterday I was explaining, if love is compassion, it will flow towards the whole world. If you hate somebody and love somebody, never think it is love. It is just attention. If you can love somebody and hate somebody else, never think what you have is love. It is only attention. If you are attended, you feel you are loved. If you attend somebody, you feel you are loving. Attention, when you give the attention, money, energy, time, everything follows. But attention means nothing else. Or love means nothing else but attention. This much only is our experience. At least let us know that we do not know. When you know you do not know, you will start knowing. When you do not know, you do not know, you don't even know, you don't know. I always tell this. If you know you don't know, at least you know you don't know. If you don't know that you don't know, you don't even know you don't know. Tell wrong, what do you want to tell?
You say love is attention. That I'm not trying to be funny, but when my boss is talking, I'm paying attention. That means I love my boss.
No, not in that attention. The attention word is not that. Your being, whole being gives attention. You see, there only your head gives attention. Your heart just wants to escape from his room. That is not attention. When your being gives attention. When I say attention, when your being gives attention. In front of your boss, you are not giving attention. You are attention. Attention is not attention. Because you are attention, you are giving attention. That is not attention. Attention is something like your whole being is attending. Doubt is clear? Mm. Yes.
People say God loves you.
Mm.
That means God giving us some attention.
See, let us not bring any hypothesis. Are you sure that God is there? Are you sure? So you please ask this question the person who talks. Now I am going to teach something down to earth. To transform your life. People come and ask me, Swamiji, give me the mantra to Vashya. Vashya means, you know, that to attract the 1800 Kali. That there is a Devi called Ashtadasabhuja Mahalakshmi Durga Devi. That Devi has got 18 hands. She is considered as a powerful goddess. They come and ask me, Swamiji, please give me the mantra to attract that 1800 Kali. I tell them, fool, first learn how to attract your wife 200 women. First know how to live with 200 women. Then you can learn how to live with the 1800 women. You do not know how to attract 200 women and live happily with her, you start going for the 1800 women. If you can't manage this 2 hand, how will you manage 18 hand? So I always tell the people, first let us start where we are staying, where we are standing. Throughout this 2 days course, you will not listen the word God, Atman, Soul. You will never listen these words, God, Brahman, Atman, Soul. No, I am not going to speak any hypothesis. I am going to speak something directly to do with your life. If I speak all these hypotheses, after the discourse, what will you do? You will go out and tell, Swami spoke so beautifully. But what is happening in your life? Nothing. So I do not want to speak anything which is impractical or which is not known in our life. So I want to deal only the things which you also know, I also know. We can go only from where you stand, where we stand. So don't bring him. Poor fellow, let him be there where he is. Let us not disturb him. Yes. Physical attraction, perfectly all right. But I tell you, physical attraction can be called as lust. Yeah, one step further is lust, the love. Attention is little bit higher. Sometimes you give attention to your daughter, to your son, you give your love. So even those things can be called as love. Even beyond physical relationship, love steps. One step ahead of relationship, physical relationships. So, whenever you are attended, you say you are loved. Whenever you attend, you say you love. The attention need is the worst disease which we have. If you scan throughout your life, it is nothing but the from morning till night, just you scan your activities. What for you are doing everything, including your household jobs. What for? It is nothing but attention need. We may say, no. I love my family, that is why I do. If you really love your family and do it, you will not wait for the certificate end of the day. At the end of the day, what do? You are just waiting that your husband should tell good wife, or your wife should tell good husband, or your son should tell good father, daughter should tell good mother. You are waiting for the good certificate. In West, I saw even the written certificates people are handing over. Good husband, good wife. In the many reception rooms, in the drawing rooms, I saw good parents award. I think to give that certificate itself, both of them must have fought. Whether I will give first or you will give first. I do not know. You wait at the end of the day for certificate. If you are not given certificate, you feel something is missing. You wait for it. After the food is being served, you wait and ask, why not open your mouth and tell it is good? At least once you can acknowledge it is good. That poor guy, what else can do? With food itself, yes. You not only wait, sometimes you even force the people to give a certificate. Attention need makes you continuously ask for the certificate from others. You can see an example of kids. The kids, they will do something. And then they will put 2-3 steps front, break some tie or do some mischievous things, and wait and turn and look at the face of the mother. If the mother agrees, if the mother doesn't show anything in her face, then they will go ahead. If she just looks at them, or if the mother doesn't recognize, then immediately they'll step back and sit. Have you seen? If you don't recognize, they will step back and sit. If you recognize, they will go ahead. Same thing.
So you said if you recognize, or I didn't see, I heard that word you said.
If you recognize, they will go ahead. If you don't recognize, they will just step back and sit quietly. Sometimes they will start crying also if you don't recognize. Same thing. If everybody praises you, pampers you, gives attention, gives you certificate, recognizes you, you feel good. You feel you are somebody. If somebody says even one word, one criticism, or if one person doesn't recognize you, immediately you feel you are missing something. Even if he is not, if he or she is not involved in your day-to-day life, routine life, you feel a low energy if somebody don't recognize you, if somebody don't pay attention to you. Why we bother so much about others' opinion? Because you come to know, you make opinion about yourself only from others' opinion. You do not have any idea about yourself. You do not have any clarity or vision about yourself. You understand about yourself only from others' opinions. When your teacher says you are a good student, you collect that opinion. When your father says you are an obedient boy, you collect that opinion. When your mother says you are looking beautiful, you collect that opinion. When your friend says you are a beautiful guy who is got all efficiency, you collect that opinion. Continuously you collect everybody's opinion and come to an understanding about yourself. Have you seen kids playing with the playing cards? They will build castles with playing cards. You see? They will build castles with playing cards. You are also building your personality with others' opinions and certificates. Kids are intelligent. They build their castles with their own cards. You are so foolish. You build your castles with others' cards, with others' opinions, with others' certificates. As long as you dance according to everyone's tune, they will let their certificate to be with you. If you don't dance for one person's tune, what will happen? What will happen? They will take away their certificate. What will happen to the castle then? That is what is continuously happening to you in your life. You try to build your castles with others' opinion, others' attention, others' recognition, others' certificate. Your life is nothing but a long signature campaign. In a book you write, I am a good husband, please sign it. Please sign it. Please sign it. It's nothing but begging for signatures. As long as you dance on it, according to everybody's tune, they will let their certificate to be with you. Imagine four sides of a stage. One side, your husband is playing rock music. You go and do a few rock steps. Other side, your mother-in-law is playing Bharatanatyam music. You go on 2-3 steps of Bharata. Third side, Kuchipudi is going on. Your son is playing. You go there and 2-3 steps. Fourth side, somebody is playing Carnatic music. You go and do 2-3 steps. If you are jump simply this side, that corner, this corner, and in between you have to dance your own dance also. If this is the case, what you will be doing? It will never be a dance, it will be only a mess. How long you can dance for everybody's tune? How long? No. When you don't dance for somebody's tune, what they will do? They will take away their certificate. Then immediately you feel one of your leg is fractured. Don't think you walk with two legs. You are like centipede. You are walking with 100 legs. All the 100 persons' opinion, if they are good, you perfectly go. Your life goes smoothly. If someone's opinion is taken, what happens? You are handicapped.